New Zealand is one of the most at-risk countries in the world for a tsunami. In any one century, there's probably a chance of several large destructive tsunamis to hit New Zealand.
Distant source ones, which come for South America and places like that, we have lots of warning time, and therefore we can get an official warning out to communities in the coastal areas. If you're in a coastal community, your council has the responsibility of warning you as to whether you need to evacuate or move to higher ground, move inland, and they have various range of mechanisms which they'll use to do that, ranging from sirens, the policemen, the fire service. Even telephone conversations between neighbours. The one that really worries me is the sort of tsunami that can be generated by an earthquake that occurs really close to our shores. So you get very, very short time space between the earthquake occurring and the tsunami arriving, and you can't get an official warning out, and so we rely entirely on people being able to take actions themselves.
Tsunami are never just one surge of water. So tsunami come as a series of waves, and there are two important points. The first wave may not be the largest, and tsunami waves may continue to arrive for many hours. If it's a really big tsunami, it may be causing disturbance in harbors and in the ocean for up to a day or longer. The other point about tsunami waves is that half of the time you're going to get a positive wave, so you're going to get the bulge of water arriving at the coast first, and half of the time you're going to get a negative wave arriving first, so the water will withdraw. So there's only a 50% chance of seeing that water withdrawal ahead of the wave, and in the other cases, it's the disturbance and noise from the ocean that's the only warning because you're not seeing a withdrawal of water.
I didn't understand one basic thing, that sometimes you don't get a warning. Well, I understand that now. Yeah, I have learnt that one.
They're much bigger and just much more powerful than I could ever have comprehended.
For the whole time, until I heard the wave coming and crashing all our buildings, I did not believe that it was actually happening.
Assume that it will happen and just go, move.
My advice to people when they're living in coastal communities is to think about the possibility of a tsunami in the area in which you live, to think about how you might respond with your family in that instance. So think about the escape routes that you would take, like where you would go to head inland or to go to higher ground. Think and ask about what sort of warning systems would be provided to the community by the emergency authorities. Have a think about schools and where the children might be.
There was about 60% of me was like, nothing's going to happen. I'm not, yeah, it was that you don't want to be embarrassed feeling. It was, yeah, you don't want to be starting a panic about anything.
Everything that they say to you that will happen before a tsunami happened, there was the quake, then there was a gap, and then the water drained out, and then the wave came in.
There's a few bits and pieces I missed when we, grabbed our things, which was medication and the communication, the phones and cameras, which would have been great if you could just chuck them in a bag. Somewhere close, something handy that you can grab to go if you need to.
Well, when you first go to the beach, have a look around and think, if there is an earthquake here, what would I do? Where would I run to? Where would I go?
In hindsight, I think, why did we wait? Why didn't we go? Why didn't we run? And I think that's what a lot of people have asked themselves the same question.
It's bigger than it looks, and it's faster than you think, and it's silent, and it's not going to tell you what's coming. And you'd better just run, just in case.
If you're staying at a camping ground or a resort area, or even just free camping near the beach, have a look at your surroundings and maybe make a mental picture or go for a walk and just do a bit of a recce with regard to a what-if situation.
Even if you're at the coast, in an area that is dead flat, it's still worth running inland. Every meter a tsunami travels inland, even across dead flat ground, it will drop in elevation, or every few hundred meters. So every meter inland that you manage to run, you're going to be safer from that tsunami.
Don't go sightseeing. Don't go to the beach when there's a warning in force.